Hey guys, it's Jen. Welcome back to my channel. Yes, I am coming at you again today. And before I get started into today's topic, which is, by the way, how to save money on your next Walt Disney World vacation, I want to acknowledge the elephant in the room. Okay, moving on. We're just gonna talk Disney, because I don't know about you, but I'm starting to have some anxiety, and dwelling on the situation in which we find ourselves is not actually helping me, because I can watch the news, I can get on Twitter, I can do all of those things, but here in this space, we are gonna just keep on keeping on. We are gonna keep our heads in a space about brighter days, and these daily videos, whether they are here or they are over on my Joyful Living channel, I hope to serve as a break for you and for me. Let's just get into today's topic, shall we? Okay, good, let's. Okay, the ears are going on because this is definitely an ear-worthy video. So I'm gonna tell you guys a story as I put on my ears. Let's see how those look. Pretty good, not bad. About when we were furloughed from the airlines years ago. And this is not a sad story, so don't get worried. You don't have to turn me off. But this is not my first rodeo with a really crazy economic thing happening. And we were furloughed right after 9/11, and we actually did not have any money for a very, very long time. So I realize that in this space, I talk a lot about luxury Disney, okay? I mean, I've done everything from VIP tours, by the way, which I didn't pay for, but that aside, to, you know, deluxe accommodations, to staying club level, all of those lovely fantasy things. But my expertise when I first started planning Disney trips for my family was doing it on a budget. So I actually know lots and lots and lots on how to do this, and it is definitely time for me to dust off my budget Disney skills and bring you guys some of my best tips and tricks. Now, for a lot of you that watch the channel, none of this will be revolutionary, I don't think. I don't think I'm gonna drop some big budget saving thing that you've never heard of in your life, but it might give you some ideas that you maybe haven't thought about in a while. And I know for a lot of you who have maybe had to reschedule your Disney trips, you may also be looking at scaling those trips down quite a bit. So if some of these tips enable you to still be able to go, then, you know, then I feel like that is a really good way for us to invest some time. So we're gonna go through several categories. We're gonna go through rooms, we're gonna go through tickets, we're gonna go through dining, and we're gonna go through souvenirs. And I'm gonna share my top tips in each category for maybe downsizing your Disney vacation just a little bit. Ooh, maybe that's a good title, downsizing your Disney vacation. Okay, so let's talk first of all about room selection and where you're going to stay. Now, there are a variety of options on where to stay on Disney property. The number one thing that I would like to suggest you do is find a Disney travel agent, someone that specializes in Disney travel, and ask them before you hire them, if a discount comes out, will you automatically apply that to my reservation? I have found out that actually not all travel agents do that, so you want to make sure that's something that they will take on the responsibility for, but a travel agent is a great way to do it. Also, make sure if you're going to book directly through the Walt Disney World website, make sure you know how to search for special offers on the Walt Disney World website. It's actually kind of tricky to find because up at the top, and I'm going to insert a screen recording so that I can show you exactly where that is. It says, I think, places to stay or something, but the special offer tab is actually on the other side. The other thing with the special offers is make sure that you're logged in, and sometimes you have to re-log in so that if you have access to either a military discount, maybe a DVC cash discount, by the way, they do offer very small discounts from time to time for DVC members if they're gonna pay cash, and also, of course, annual pass holder discounts, and then all of the discounts that are available to the general public. A lot of people don't know how to find that special offer tab. In fact, I was just talking to a good friend that's been planning Disney vacations for her family for as long as I have, and she didn't even know how to find it. Always check that. One of the silver linings is I do expect there will be lots of great discounts coming up for Walt Disney World accommodations. And we actually have not seen those discounts in recent years. So that's going to be one of those silver lining things. But I think we will see some good discounts come out. So make sure you're looking for that. Number two, you may want to consider downgrading. If you were booked at a deluxe, you may want to stay at a moderate. If you were booked at a moderate, you may want to stay at a value. When my kids were young, the values were not an option for us because we are a family of five. However, a lot of the moderates now will accommodate five in a room. So you really do have a lot more options than we had. And then the last thing you might want to think about, and nobody get mad at me here, staying off property. One of my favorite off property places is Bonnet Creek. My good friend Becca, if you follow her, Becca Hart, she did a great review of their stay at the Hilton at Bonnet Creek at the timeshare. They had a great stay there, and you're actually on Disney property there, so that's a great option. There are a lot of Disney Good Neighbor hotels now that offer the 60-day fast pass booking window. You just have to make sure they're classified as a Good Neighbor hotel, but definitely check out offsite options. A bit of a caveat on offsite options: check those resort fees, because they can actually add up quickly and make what seems like a really great deal not be such a great deal. So before you click confirm, and one of the things that drives me crazy about like Expedia and a lot of the hotel booking sites is they don't include that resort fee in the price that they're giving you. So definitely make sure you're comparing apples to apples. But again, this can be a great time to find some great deals. And actually, staying off property is not the worst thing ever. I would much rather stay off property than not be able to go at all. And there are some great choices off property. If you've stayed in a great resort that you love that's off Disney property, I would love for you to put that in the comments below. Because we're DVC members, I haven't stayed off property as much, so I don't have as much to offer there, but definitely would love to hear from some of you. All right, so now let's move on to category number two, which is tickets. Now, the biggest money saver I can give you for tickets is consider not adding on the park hopper option. You will save as much as $100 per ticket, sometimes even more depending on the season, by not adding on that park hopper option. And truly, for years, when I scheduled trips with our family, we did not use the park hopper. We just would go to one park each day. In some ways, it makes it even more convenient and easier to plan, because we're only going to be in this one park. We need to get our three fast passes, and the whole day is planned out. I just think that is something that you can easily plan around and still have a fantastic vacation. Another great tip for tickets is to make sure you look into something like Undercover Tourist. We have used Undercover Tourist for years. I absolutely love them. Their tickets, you still can link them to My Disney Experience. All the normal things apply. And if you are subscribed to the Mouse Savers newsletter, and I'm going to put that link below, Mary usually has a special discount code that gives you even better discounts off of Undercover Tourist already discounted tickets. So they are the only discount ticket broker that I would use, not affiliated. I have literally used them for years. The only thing to be aware of if you buy through them, years ago, if you bought through them and then you upgraded the ticket, Disney would apply the full price. Now they have some way to know how much you paid. So you'll only get the price you paid applied to, let's say, if you upgraded to an annual pass or something like that. But still, you can save, especially if you have a family of five, you can save quite a bit of money, and they will do digital delivery immediately. So absolutely love Undercover Tourist. All right, number three, let's talk about dining. Now, dining at Disney, as we know, can be very expensive. I am a table service girl all the way. I love dining at Disney, but there are great ways to save money. The number one way is to consider paring down how many table service restaurants you're going to. I would say cut them out entirely, but there's just something about some of these Disney restaurants. To me, it really does make the vacation. So what I might be inclined to do if we were doing a six-night trip, instead of doing six table service restaurants, I might cut that down to three, and I might even consider doing pizza delivery one night, maybe going off property one night, doing counter service. If I'm in a villa, I might bring some food in. Those are great options. And then when it comes to counter service, really look at the kids' meals. We were just at, I can never remember the name, something Roadhouse, that new one, American Eagle Roadhouse, that just opened in the America Pavilion. But if you watched my last vlog, I went there with my friend Brooke, and Coral and I both got these really expensive meals, and Brooke, girlfriend, walked out of there spending like $6.50 because she got the kids meal, and the kids meal was huge. Not only are the kids meals available to adults, not only are they usually plenty of food, but a lot of the time they're healthier than the adult meals. So you might be getting, you know, carrots or something a little bit healthier to add into your Disney dining. So you're saving money and you're eating healthier, and most of the time it comes with a drink. So it's kind of this whole package of better deal. So if you're not a huge eater, ordering a kid's meal is a fantastic way to save money. And by the way, Disney does not care if someone who is not a kid orders a kid's meal. So don't worry about that. The only time you'll run into trouble is if you have a kid on the dining plan trying to order an adult meal. So on the dining plan, you wouldn't want to do that. But if you're trying to save a lot of money, you're probably not doing the dining plan anyway. And if you want to know why I don't think the dining plan will save you any money, you can go watch my video right here. Okay, another great way to save on dining is to get some groceries, either delivered in advance, you can use Garden Grocer, you can use Amazon Prime, and get things like, you know, bottled water if your family drinks that, you can get yogurts to put in the in-room fridge, you can do oatmeal packets that you can easily do with hot water from the coffee maker. I know that grosses some people out, but we've done that for years. If you're in a DVC villa, you'll have a microwave, so that gives you a lot more options, but you know, everything from Pop-Tarts to donuts. If you can at least do breakfast in the room before you leave, and you know what? It's vacation. So don't worry if it's not the healthiest thing in the world. Just get some food in those kids' bellies before you head out to the park. And then you can maybe, you know, save a little bit of money because they will have had a good breakfast. Also, bringing snacks can be a great idea. I love Disney snacks, but you may not want to do quite as many if you're on a budget, and you may want to bring some of your own snacks. They are totally fine if you bring food into the park. The only thing you're not allowed to do is like wheel in a big old cooler, although I have seen people do that, but you know, I digress. You definitely can bring in like Clif bars and granola bars and string cheese and things like that. So definitely consider packing your own snacks for your family. So the last category I'm going to talk about is saving money on souvenirs. Now, for years, when we would go to Disney after we were unemployed, we had zero money for the kids for souvenirs. So we would usually ask grandparents to give Disney gift cards because then they would have that money to spend in the parks, or set a budget and then give your children and yourself a gift card for that amount to spend in the parks. I find if you have that conversation in advance, it really cuts down on the gimmies once they get there. Another fun option is to buy things in advance at Walmart or Target or the dollar store and bring them as little Tinkerbell gifts for your kids, because then they know that they have a really fun surprise every day. And those can be little souvenirs that are oftentimes very similar to what you're going to find in the parks, but for a fraction of the cost. So, you know, send them with a gift card, say this is all the money you have. And by the way, that's also a great way to teach them budgeting, because they know I have, you know, a $25 or a $50 gift card, and this is all that I have. And then also giving them those far less expensive little Tinkerbell gifts that you have wrapped up and brought from home. So my last tip, which will actually apply to everything that I've talked about, surely by now you guys have heard me say, but I don't know, maybe you haven't, is to buy discounted Disney gift cards before your trip. And the best way that I found to do this was to budget out however many months we had before our trip and then break it down. And every month for me at Target, I know you can also get them at BJ's, but I get mine at Target. I use my red card, which they have a credit and a debit option, so you don't have to use a credit card for this. You get 5% off of the Disney gift cards. So, you know, I just usually at Target once a month anyway. So let's say I thought we were going to spend $3,000 on our vacation. I would divide that by however many months I had before the trip, and I would start buying those gift cards in advance. You can then go to DisneyGiftCards.com, and I can never remember if it's Disney gift card or Disney gift cards, but I'll put it right here and also in the description box. And then you can combine all those cards onto one card. I think up to $250 on each card. It might even be $500, but I think it's $250. So that way, you can even pay your room balance. You can pay for your... The only thing you can't do is if you use Undercover Tourist, obviously you can't use that for your tickets. But if you were going to purchase your tickets through Disney, you could use that for your tickets. Lots of different ways that you can use those gift cards. And then obviously, when you get there, you can use those gift cards to pay for dining. Now, if you don't want to have to be pulling out a gift card and you're someone who wants to just use their magic band, obviously this is not a magic band. Who wants to use their magic band, as long as you go down every couple of days and pay off your balance, you can pay off your balance that you've charged to your magic band with your gift card. So you can still totally do it that way. The caveat there is make sure you don't wait until like the afternoon before you check out, because that's usually when they start to process things. But you can 100% just pay off your balance during your trip using those gift cards. So you could really pay for your entire trip with that 5% discount. So those are my top tips for saving money on a Walt Disney World vacation, maybe downsizing your Walt Disney World vacation. What tips do you have? I know you guys are a wealth of knowledge on this subject, and I know there are a lot of families that have had to cancel their trips as the parks are closed right now. And I know that being able to plan and dream, and even if you have to downsize that vacation to get it on the calendar for some time, maybe summer, maybe it's fall, maybe it's all the way until next spring, but just knowing for you, for your littles, for everyone involved, that you have that great thing to look forward to is going to go a long way towards giving you a big dose of hope. So I hope you like this video. If you liked it, please make sure you give it a big thumbs up. Make sure you subscribe to the channel and check back every single day until this thing is over, either on this channel or over on Joyful Living, and I will have a new video for you guys every day. I hope you're having a good one. I hope you're taking care of yourself and those that you love, and I'll talk to you soon. Bye-bye.